नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय। नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय। रामेश्वराय शिव रामेश्वराय, हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय। रामेश्वराय शिव रामेश्वराय, हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय। ओम नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, हर भोले नमः शिवाय। नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय।
हाय ऑल, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल संकल्प टू एक्सप्लोर इंडिया। एज पर एनालिटिक्स, ओनली 4% ऑफ द व्यूअर्स आर सब्सक्राइब्ड टू आवर चैनल। Please subscribe to our channel to support us, like the video and leave your valuable comments which will help us to improve. Today we are traveling to Avni, a small village in Mulabagilu Taluk, Kolar district in Karnataka, India, about 10 miles from Kolar gold fields. The village is located at 32 kilometers from Kolar, the district center, and 13 kilometers from Mulabagilu, the taluk headquarters, and around 95 kilometers from Bengaluru city center. Avni is known for the Sita temple situated on a hill and also for Ramalingeshwara temple, which is our destination today. The Ramalingeshwara group of temples, situated in Avni town of the Kolar district, is constructed in the Dravida style. According to the Archaeological Survey of India, the temple is an ornate 10th century Nolamba dynasty construction, which was partially renovated later by the Chola dynasty. The Vijayanagara kings built main Mandapam and Rajgopuram. The temple is protected by the Archaeological Survey of India as a monument of national importance. The temple complex comprises four major shrines, one each for Rama, Lakshmana, Bharata and Shatrughna. There are other minor shrines, such as those for Vali and Sugriva. The Ramalingeshwara temple or Rameshwar consists of a sanctum, Garbhagriha, a vestibule, antarala and a hall, Navranga, with decorative pillars. The base, Adhishthana, of the temple comprises mouldings articulated with Kirtimukha and lions in relief. The outer walls have pilasters surmounted by Dravida towers. The first temple you find once you enter temple complex is Subramanya temple. Here is the main temple of Lord Shiva, who is worshipped as Ramalingeshwara. Puja is offered at morning and evening times. If you visit at these times, you can visit the main deity or else you will find it closed. Videography and photography is restricted inside the main temple. A Nandi idol and few idols as well can be seen inside the temple. You can see carvings of Shiva, Parvati, Lord Vishnu and Ganesha on the outer pillars of Ramalingeshwara temple. The external decorative elements for all shrines include 5 moldings ornamented with friezes of elephants, lions, yali, makra above which are wall pilasters and reliefs of yakshas, dwarpalas, images of Shiva, Bhairava, Bharavi, Vishnu and Ganesha. The Lakshmanalingeshwara temple or Lakshmaneshwara, which houses the largest linga, has a depiction of the noted 10th century saint Tribhuvanakata holding a Rudraksh necklace on a wall. The pillars in the hall as well as in the Bharatalingeshwara or Bharateshwara shrine have several relief sculptures. The ceiling has a fine sculpture of Umamaheswar Shiva with consort Parvati, surrounded by an ensemble of Ashtadikpalas. Ashta means 8, Dik means directions and Pala means guardian, that means guardians in 8 directions. Avni is a place of great antiquity. According to the Archaeological Survey of India, an inscription here dated 399 AD refers to it. Later inscriptions call Avni, Gaya of the South. Here is the Shatrughneshwara temple. And on the walls below there are inscriptions about the temple in Halegannada. Inscriptions can still be read clearly and same can be seen on both sides of the temple. Even Shatrughneshwara has a linga as deity, and the different carvings on the pillars compared to other temples of this complex. Legend has it that Avni was the abode of the Hindu saint Valmiki, who is author of the epic Ramayana, and that the Hindu god Rama visited Avni during his return to Ayodhya from Lanka. According to the legend, Rama's sons Lava and Kush were born here on an existing hill called Lavakush Betta, a short distance from the temple complex. On the left-hand side end of the temple complex, there is a Vigneshwara temple dedicated to Lord Ganesha. Even on the walls behind the temple, there are carvings of Lord Brahma, Vishnu and Maheshwara. This is Bharateshwara temple, one of the main temples in the complex and located exactly opposite side of other 3 temples in right side of temple complex. A Nandi idol can be seen outside the temple facing Lord Shiva. Opposite to Bharateshwara temple, you can find a temple in the name of Vali and Sugriva. Next to this temple, you can also find a temple named as Lingeshwara. The temple complex also has a temple for Navagrahas. You can also plan to visit Sita Temple on the hill, which is shown in video. Since temple was closed, we returned without visiting hilltop. On next visit, we will cover Sita Temple as well. Thank you all for watching. Please do not forget to subscribe to channel and support us. Do leave your valuable comments on what was good and what needs improvement. Signing off, Sankalp.